Absent Friends by S.J. Rozan, read by Barbara McCulloh.
All I know is that the surest way to make enemies is to always tell the truth. So its nature, probably, is quite complex. José Latour. Powerless is speech. Still, it bests a tear in attempts to reach crossing the frontier. Joseph Brodsky, A Martial Law Carol. Boy's Own Book. Chapter 1. Secrets No One Knew. July 4th, 1976. Four boys, three girls, high and soaring, skin sizzling, tingling under the dizzying stars. Everything open and opening. The ragtop to the sky endlessly to the huge summer night. This night to their limitless lives. Everything opening. In the black sky, tight, bright bursts eclipse the luminous moon, explode as fiery streaks, fountains of scarlet, rockets of silver, purple blooms, and sprays of green. On the radio, rising swells of tinny music. From the car, shouts and applause. Everything opening. The girls to the boys. Not for the first time, but with a new, laughing heat. The boys to each other. Grunts and shrugs and grins, their fiercely sworn oaths. Beer cans, their glittering tokens of fealty. Everything. Everything opening. Surprisingly, newly, the boys to the girls. The boys? One is quiet, and one sure. One eager, and one flying, as always, too near the sun. The girls are royalty to these boys, have been since their memories began. And now, as the boys turn into men, the girls are knowing, wise, and real to them in ways they are not yet to themselves. All would tell you. And on this patriotic night, this celebration of association, when people all around them are reveling in the sheer, staggering luck of being born into the community they would most want to be part of, what are they feeling, these boys and girls? Not fear. Not on a night like this, when together they could conquer invading intergalactic armies. With grace and ease, they could defeat rock-blind, howling swamp men, burning with destruction. Not fear, but the hope of an anchor. The need for each other's weight in the whirlwind. You are here, marked on a mental map. One of the boys leaving in the morning. Everyone else to stay. All have been told by men and women, older and more tired, that the marked spot shrinks to nothing, that no ballast can hold, that the buoy above the anchor disappears in the bobbling waves. None of the seven believes it. It can be said that here the story begins, though it has been going on for some time. No story has a true beginning, and none has an ending, either. From the New York Tribune, October 16th, 2001. A Hero Remembered, Captain James McCaffrey, by Harry Randall. Third in a series of profiles of the lost heroes of September 11th. Note to readers. September 11th produced countless heroes. Many are still with us. Others perished. Some final acts of bravery and sacrifice will never be known. The New York Tribune joins a grateful city in saluting all our unsung heroes. There are others among the lost whose final deeds stand out in memory. In this series, the Tribune profiles some of these heroes as a testimony to their courage and to the character and pride of all New Yorkers. First in, last out. With these words, spoken by a surviving member of Ladder Company 62, Captain James McCaffrey was eulogized before a crowd of 2,500 at a memorial service at St. Patrick's Cathedral on Monday, October 15th. McCaffrey, 46, was one of the most decorated firefighters in the history of the New York City Fire Department, and the focus of a memorial fund was remembered by speakers including the mayor, the fire...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.